Hi, I'm going to show you how to download the Hoopla app to your tablet or phone and register with your Anchorage Public Library card. Hoopla gives you access to ebooks, audiobooks, magazines, music, and videos with no holds or waiting lists. Before we get started, you will need a fully verified library card from the Anchorage Public Library that is in good standing. Hoopla has a monthly checkout limit that resets on the first of each month. Here is the current monthly checkout limit. Please note this limit can change, so check with library staff if you are unsure about Hoopla checkouts. To get started, you'll need to go to your App Store. Now, I'm demonstrating on an iPhone, so it may look slightly different on your device, but you should be able to search for Hoopla wherever you go to get new apps for your device. Hoopla is free, so once you find it, go ahead and install it on your device. Now that you have the app, open it and tap on Sign Up to create your Hoopla account. Tap Let's Go and then search for your library. If you have location settings enabled, you can let Hoopla find your library, or you can just start typing Anchorage. Once you've selected Anchorage Public Library, you'll be prompted to enter your library card number. This is the 14-digit number on the back of your card without the spaces. Your PIN is the code you chose when you registered for a card. If you don't know or can't remember your PIN, call or stop by the library to find this information out. Tap Next, and then you'll be prompted to enter your email address. Once you've done that, you'll need to choose a password that is at least 8 characters long. The Hoopla app generally stays logged in, but if you do get logged out or want to log into Hoopla from a new device, you'll need to remember the password you chose. It's not shared with the library. Once you've chosen your password, tap on Sign Up, then Get Started, and then tap Log In. When you first open Hoopla, you'll see some icons at the bottom of the screen. The My Hoopla button displays what you currently have borrowed. Since Hoopla has a monthly limit of borrows, this screen also shows you how many titles you have left. Checkouts reset on the first of each month. You can tag titles, series, or people, such as authors or performers, as favorites by tapping the heart icon, and those things will show up here as favorites. And if you go back to the Borrowed tab and scroll down, you can see a history of titles you've borrowed. The search icon is where you will come to look up titles, authors, or series. Choose the settings icon to update your personal settings, including email address and password, library settings to update your library card number or PIN if they change, and notification settings to determine how you will receive notifications about your checkouts. You can also link to streaming devices such as Roku, Amazon Fire, or Chromecast from this screen. Tap the home icon in the bottom left corner to get back to the main screen. You can browse the different types of formats Hoopla offers by tapping on one of the white tabs just underneath the scrolling picture. The categories are audiobooks, comics, ebooks. These all check out for 3 weeks. Then we have music, which checks out for 1 week. Movies and television, which check out for 72 hours. And binge passes. Binge passes give you access to a large amount of content for 1 week. One of the most popular binge passes is magazines. When you check out the magazine binge pass, you have access to over 100 different magazines for the entire week. Hoopla is constantly adding or changing their binge pass offerings. Current options include Hallmark movies, documentaries from Curiosity Stream, The Great Courses, puzzles, and comics, as well as many different passes with children's content. Unlike individual books or movies, binge passes are too large to be downloaded to your device, so you will need to be connected to Wi-Fi to access titles in a binge pass. If you have a specific title you're searching for, Tap the search icon and a search bar will appear at the top of your screen where you can type in titles, authors, or subjects. Depending on what you searched, you may get results in more than one format. When you find something you want to borrow, tap on it, then tap the Borrow button. Downloading to your device may start automatically, but if it doesn't, tap Download to your device to access your title offline. Now when you go to My Hoopla, you can see your borrowed title and pick up where you left off reading, watching, or listening. And that's your quick start guide to using the Hoopla app. There's still lots more to know about Hoopla, and I encourage you to explore. Thanks for watching!